What's up guys, Christopher Walker here back again. Going to be talking today about some of my favorite sources of B12 that I recommend for people. Obviously you can use B12 and correct your deficiencies and that sort of thing using supplements. And that's a very convenient, easy way. B12 supplements are actually usually really affordable. It's pretty common to find them. I recommend going with methylcobalamin in terms of if you want the most absorbable form of B12, so you can get more bang for your buck. But there are also some good foods that you can be consuming, because if you are deficient, that means that you probably weren't consuming the right foods in the first place and doing things that were going to make you become deficient in B12 in the first place. So just incorporating some of these foods into your regular weekly diet can be a very easy way to make sure that you have enough in it, especially the first food I'm going to talk about today, because it literally, in 3 ounces of this food, it contains 3,375% of what the FDA says is the recommended daily amount of B12. So it contains a ridiculous amount. And by just consuming this on a regular basis, you can help to combat a deficiency. But the other ones I'm going to show you also have a very, very high percentage of B12. So let's get into it. All right, the first food that you can have that's a good source of B12 is liver. And this could be, you know, a good beef liver, good chicken liver, that sort of thing. Make sure you get the good animals, though, or you're going to get some garbage up in the liver. So get, you know, organic. If you can get it from a local farm, that's even better. Just don't buy like the bottom shelf liver, you're gonna get some nasty stuff. But the good liver is an incredible source. Just 3 ounces has 81 milligrams of B12, which is, like I said, over 3,000% of the recommended daily amount. Woohoo! And I talk about liver a lot. I mean, I recommend it. If you can get a good stuff, you know, good liver is gonna have a ton of vitamins and minerals in it. It's got way more than just B12 in it. All right, next up is salmon. Salmon in general has, you know, like per filet of salmon is going to have almost 20 milligrams of B12. So that's about a quarter of what the tiny 3 ounces of liver would have. But it's still quite a lot. It clocks in over 800% of the recommended daily amount. There are other fish in general that are going to have this too. I mean, herring is one, mackerel, sardines, tuna, trout. They all have very high amounts of B12 in them. So if you like fish, that can be a good option. I don't personally eat a ton of fish, but some people like to eat a lot of fish. Another one is turkey. Turkey's pretty solid. It's okay. I mean, it's got a lot in it, like relatively to other food, but not compared to those like the liver or the fish. Turkey has, for every 3 ounce, has about 1 milligram of B12.
Dad loves Thanksgiving. It's his favorite holiday.
Will it be you? You're a big one. Have you been working out?
A little.
Well, you look great.
Yeah, it's a little weird.
Raw milk, too, which not a lot of people drink raw milk. It's extremely hard to find. As far as I know, it's illegal in the U.S. to even sell it. But if, you know, people on a farm might be able to get it. Also has 1 milligram of B12 in it per cup. And beef tenderloin, so if you like tenderloin, it's got a decent amount. It's got about 1 milligram as well per 3 ounces. So, you know, a steak's going to have probably about, like, one steak will have the recommended daily amount of B12 in it. And then lamb is another one. It's about the same as the steak. So there you have it. Those are some really rich food sources in B vitamins in general, but especially B12. Again, take note, the beef, chicken liver, that the liver has a ridiculous amount. So if you even consume that once every couple weeks, you're going to be fighting back against any sort of deficiencies, that's for sure. So that's really good. Now, basically for vegetarians and vegans, the main issue is that a lot of B vitamins are going to come from meat. And like in terms of like dietary sources, if you're not taking a B12 supplement. So if you're a vegan or vegetarian, it's a very high likelihood that you are deficient in B12, especially because it's the most common deficiency around the entire world. You know, a lot of vegans and vegetarians go towards something like blue or green algae. Basically, they tout it as a superfood that's very absorbable, but it's actually not. It was found to not be a very absorbable source of B12. In the body. So it's definitely recommended in order to prevent the deficiency or correct the deficiency to use a supplement to do so. If you are a vegan or vegetarian, you can get a good methylcobalamin supplement and just use that. So hopefully you thought this was helpful. Again, you know, just a reference, we have inflammation relief. Our Truth Nutra supplement has methylcobalamin in it and a great amount. and you can find that at truthnutra.com. If you like this video, give it a like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.